So why might we care to do this, Michael? So there's a bunch of reasons, but really it boils down to two. One is really about human beings, and the other is really about machines and machine learning algorithms. And the first one really boils down to what I'll just call knowledge discovery. Right? It is often useful when you're thinking about a set of data and a problem to be able to interpret the features, to figure out, well, which subset of features that I've been keeping track of, say, or that I'm using in my sensors actually matter. And so really, the feature selection problem, for what other reasons you might think of doing it, are often good for interpretability and for insight. So it turns out that of the 1,000 features that I keep track of, only a few matter. Maybe only 10 of them matter for solving some problem of prediction. So let's think about our spam case, for example. There are lots and lots and lots of features that we might care about in the spam case, but it may turn out that after we do some kind of analysis, that it really all boils down to something like whether you're getting mail from a Nigerian prince, for example. And some of these things that you thought mattered don't seem to matter for the purposes of solving some problem or for doing prediction. And so often this is a very, very useful thing to do. You do this kind of thing all the time, Michael. Actually, if you go back and you look at some of the things we've been giving for examples, you come up with problems and features that are, for example, visible in two dimensions as opposed to three or four or five, because it's easy for you to visualize them and to understand them and for students to understand how the algorithms work in 2D.
That makes sense.
Does that all make sense? Okay. So that's one thing, and this really should not be underestimated. People tend to ignore this a lot at least in the machine learning field, much less in the data mining field. But this really is a sort of key and an important issue. But there's another reason we might care about it that's algorithmic, and that is the curse of dimensionality. So do you remember what the curse of dimensionality is, Michael?
Yeah. As you add more features, you may need exponentially more data to kind of fill out the space.
The curse of dimensionality says that the amount of data that you need grows exponentially in the number of features that you have. So it would be really nice if you could have fewer features. So the problem of feature selection helps us, hopefully, at least in a nice world, to go from a whole bunch of features to just a few features, thus making the learning problem actually easier.
Looks a little bit like an alien smiley face now.
That's right. So we came with an alien frowny face in the beginning, and then we end up with an alien smiley face. Okay, so do you buy these reasons, Michael?
Yeah, I like how you managed to, you know, if X is the input space here, you've managed to map X to Y.
Michael uses the feature transformation function known as the pun. That's really good. I like that. Okay, so let's keep all this in mind when we're talking about all the algorithms that we're talking about in this lesson and even in the feature transformation lesson. The goal is to be able to use, in general, a bunch of features because you think they all might be important, and then apply some kind of algorithm to get to just the important features. And if you can do that well, then not only will you understand your data better, but you'll also have an easier learning problem.
Got it.